गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू महालक्ष्मी अकेडमी. सो दिस इज द फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ ईटेप्स. बिफोर दिस देर वर थ्री लेक्चर. सो वॉट वी इन फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड हाउ वी कुड डिफाइन मटेरियल प्रॉपर्टीज. वी डिफाइंड M25 ग्रेड ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट एंड स्टील ऑफ HYSD-415. इन सेकेंड लेक्चर इन ऑल्सो वी सॉ हाउ वी डिफाइन सेक्शन प्रॉपर्टीज. इन फ्रेम सेक्शन वी डिफाइंड बीम 230,600, कॉलम 300,600, कॉलम 600,300. ओके. इन स्लैब सेक्शन वी डिफाइन स्लैब 150 mm थिकनेस. इन सेकेंड लेक्चर वी सॉ हाउ वी कुड ड्रॉ बीम, हाउ वी कुड ड्रॉ कॉलम, हाउ वी कुड ड्रॉ स्लैब. ओके. इन थर्ड लेक्चर वी सॉ हाउ वी कुड डिवाइड और मर्ज स्लैब, or how we could divide or join beams, how we could trim it, how we could extend it. So this is the fourth lecture. We will study how we could apply dead load, live load, support load in this particular structure. Okay. So let us begin. So let us have a random check over this. Right click, slab 150. Okay. Slab 150. Okay. Slab 150. Okay. Just we will check for beam also. Right click, beam 230,600. Beam 230,600, beam 230,600. Okay, no issue with this. So we'll just and we will also check for column. Right click, column 300,600. Anywhere here. Right click, column 300,600. So no issue. Everything is okay. So whatever property we wanted to assign to this, it's been assigned. So we'll go and define load patterns. In this there was a dead load initially with self weight multiplier 2, live load with self weight multiplier 0, and the type will be loud. Now we have added one more load, SIDL, and from here we have chosen super dead load. We have typed the name by typing SIDL. In this way I have typed the name by clicking on add new load. Type SIDL and type I have choose super dead load. Okay, and the self weight multiplier I have kept it to end. Now how to use the super dead load we will see in upcoming minutes. So before that we will complete the modeling part. So we will here are two arrows over there which will take us in upward direction and downward direction. Suppose we take it in downward direction, we are now in plinth level. So click on quick draw beams. Make sure the property is beam 230,600. So just select like this. Okay, this is beam 230,600. Then quick draw columns and choose property as column 300,600 and quick draw columns. Okay, in this way columns has been drawn. Okay, now we will choose quick draw slabs. So we will choose quick draw slab and let the property be slab 150, which is of 150 mm thickness. Okay, just we will draw one slab over here, which is the staircase slab for plinth beam, plinth level. Apart from it, we will not draw any slab. Okay, this is the plinth level. Now we will again go in terrace level. Okay, terrace level, quick draw slab beams, and we will make sure the property is beam 230,600. We will draw all beams, columns 300,600. Again, we will select column 300,600 and slab also we will draw all the slab for terrace level also, because there is waterproofing provided over there. So we will draw slab for all over here. Okay, now we will go one level ahead and this is the water tank. Okay, there is one option, a quick draw beams. We will just draw beams over here, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the four beams. And we will draw columns, and we will just draw four columns over here. This one is for the water tank, which is will come just ahead of the above the staircase. So quick draw floor, and this is the slab. Okay, we are complete with the modeling part. Now we have to just apply the loads. Okay, how we will apply the load? Let's come over here. In the plinth, 1.2 meter is the plinth height, and remaining is the 3 meter. So 3.6 meter, because 600 mm is the depth of the beam, and 1.2 meter plus floor to floor at 3 meter, which will come to 4.2 meter, and 600 mm is the depth of the beam. So what remaining is the 3.6 meter. So 3.6 into 0.15, which is the thickness of the wall, into 10 density of C4X blocks, which will be equal to 3.6 into 1.5 is equal to 5.4 kilonewton per meter. This is for the plinth level, and for this For remaining floors, 3 meter is the floor to floor height, 600 mm is the depth of the beam. So 300 minus 3 meter minus 0.6 is equal to 2.4. 2.4 into 0.15 thickness of the wall into density of say 4x blocks will be 2.4 into 1.5 is equal to 3.6. We will apply it, then we will understand. So we will just first go in first floor. Before that, come in base level, click on plan, come in base level, apply. Okay, just select all the points over here, and by selecting points, just go in assign, joints, restraints, and here is the option fix one. Okay, click on apply. We have make all sure, we have made sure that all the columns are fixed. Okay, so we will now go in by clicking here, we will go in first floor. Okay, and now here we will go in structural object, first floor, beams, select, assign, frame load, distributed. For first floor, what I said, 3 meter minus 600 mm depth of the beam, so 2.4 meters. So 2.4 into 0.15 into 10 is equal to 2.4 into 1.5 is equal to 3.6. So this will be equal to 3.6. Before that, this is super dead load. Okay, so we will make sure here we are type 3.6. Click on apply, click on OK. We could see a super dead load being assigned to all the beams of all the beam of first floor. Okay, now we will see some calculation of super dead load. Okay, for super dead load, for bathroom, passage, kitchen, living, it is 1.5 kilonewton per meter square. For shell, for floor, for balcony, 20 into 0.2 is equal to 4 kilonewton per meter square. For toilet, this 0.2 came from, because for bathroom or balcony, the sunk of 200 mm is applied. So 200 mm is equal to 0.2 meter. Therefore, it becomes 20 into 0.2, 4 kilonewton per meter square. For toilet, the sunk is of 450 mm. So 200 into 0.45 become 9 kilonewton per meter square. For staircase, it become 3 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so we will apply it for this lab. So here only we will select floors, right click, select. Now we have selected all the floors. We'll just have a look over here. Yes, all the floors on the first level have been selected. So assign, and we will go in shell load uniform. We'll choose SIDL. Okay, and the load of, let's keep it to 4 for all the floors, because here the maximum value is 4, except for toilet, it is 9 kilonewton per meter square. When we are going to work actually on plan, we will, but for the beam of particular slab, we'll apply this value only 1.549. For this, as we have taken only grace, so let us apply the maximum value nearest 4. So click on apply, click on OK. Okay, this is for SIDL of 4 kilometer. Here is one option, previous selection. So click on it, all the previous selection will be done. Click on assign, shell load, uniform, and for live load, I will just type 3. I will also explain why live load 3 is being applied. So 3, okay, done. Now here we could see live load for kitchen, living, bedroom, it is 2 kilonewton per meter square. For passage, toilet, bathroom, balcony, it is 3 kilonewton per meter square. For terrace, if it is accessible, it is 1.5 kilonewton per meter square. If it is unaccessible, it is 0.75 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, just this is for the live load. So we will again go back. And now we have applied a super dead load on beam, super dead load on floor, and live load on floor. So we will just select all this on the first floor, whatever is there. We will go in edit, edit, replicate, and we will go in story. So we'll choose second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Click on apply, click on OK. Okay, we just in 3D view, it is been copied till 7th plan. I will verify later whether loads has been copied or not in 7th floor. Obviously it has been copied, but for confirmation purpose I will verify later. Right now I will go in plinth level. Okay, plinth level, here for plinth it is 4.2 meter minus 3.6, which is equal minus 0.6, that is 600 mm depth of the beam. So 3.6 meter, so 3.6 into 150 wall thickness, that is 0.15 into 10 is equal to 5.4 kilonewton per meter. So select, we will here select from here, just go in plinth level, beams, right click, select, all the beams on the plinth level has been selected, assign, frame load distributed SIDL. Now it will be 5.4 kilonewton per meter. Okay, click on apply, click on OK. This is 5.4 kilonewton per meter. So we have selected this slab. Again here we will apply 3 and 3 only, super dead load, and assign shell load uniform for SIDL 3. Click on apply. Now we could see 3 SIDL. Again we will go in previous selection, assign shell load uniform live load 3. Click on apply. Okay, this is the select this, click on apply, click on OK. Okay, so here for staircase it was 3 kilonewton per meter square, and live load also we have applied 3 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so this is for the plinth level. Now we will go for the terrace. Right click. Okay, this is terrace level. We will minimize from here. Terrace beams, right click, select. Okay, assign shell load. Before that, frame loads distributed. Now here I will type the value as 1.8. how this 1.8 value came from, let's say from here terrace. For terrace, the parapet wall, the height is around 1.2 meter. Okay, 1.2 meter into 0.15 is the thickness of the wall into 10 into density of safer blocks, therefore it is 1.8 kilonewton per meter square. Click on apply, click on OK. It is 1.8 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, this is for terrace. Again we will for terrace, again we will right click on floors, select. We have selected the floors on the terrace. Okay, so assign shell load uniform, and here it will be SIDL will be 3 kilonewton per meter square. How 3 kilonewton per meter square, we will see from here. The waterproofing which is being provided at the terrace is of 150 mm thickness. So 150 mm thickness into 20 is the density of the material used, which is equal to 3 kilonewton per meter square. So we will go in ETEPS. Okay, so we will just apply, click on apply. Okay, this is 3 kilonewton per meter square SIDL. Again I will go for previous selection. Again the floors on the slabs have been selected. Assign shell load uniform, live load. Live load how much? 1.5. how 1.5 I will explain from here. For terrace, accessible live load is 1.5 kilonewton per meter square, and unaccessible live load is 0.75 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so let us definitely, if it is tower, it will be accessible. So let it skip it 1.5. Click on 1.5. click on OK. Okay, so live load of 1.5 kilonewton per meter square being is assigned to the terrace. Now just one thing is remaining. We need to apply some on terrace. Okay, for terrace, these are the, I will select just these four beams, assign. Now I will assign 11.5, assign frame load distributed 11.5. how this 11.5 came from, I will explain in PPT. Okay, for water tank SIDL is equal to, we have considered it twice the load of the others, therefore 2 into 0.23 is the 230 mm is the thickness of the wall. So 2 meter is the depth of the water tank, sorry, and 0.23 is the thickness of the wall. The wall of water tank is 230 mm in thickness, and density is 25 kilonewton per meter cube. Therefore it becomes 11.5 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, so we will just type here 11.5, click on apply, click on OK. Okay, this is 11.5 SIDL. Again I will select this slab which is there over here, assign shell load uniform. I will go for SIDL, and SIDL, the shell load is of 2 kilonewton per meter square, and live load is maximum over here because it is the water, and water has a maximum load. I also mentioned in the previous lectures. So shell load of 2 kilonewton per meter square. So I will just SIDL 2 kilonewton per meter square. Okay, click on apply, click on OK. Again I will go for previous selection, assign shell load uniform and live. Let's keep it to 20. So click on apply, click on OK. In this way, I have assigned load from plinth level to remaining 7 floors, also on terrace and also on water tank. So thank you everyone for watching this video. I request you to please like, comment, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel Mahalakshmi Academy. Keep watching. Thank you.